Give us a brief introduction.
I am Pratik Sahu. I am from Baleswar. I have completed my class 10 from Town High School, Jaleswar, Baleswar in the year 2006. Then I have completed my plus 2 in the year 2008 from Fakir Mohan Junior College. I have completed my graduation in Electrical Engineering from CET Bhubaneswar. Now I am working as Assistant Manager in OPTCL Sambalpur Grid. My hobbies include following football and travelling.
Okay. So, you are already working with the state government, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, you have joined as in the technical cadre?
Technical cadre, yes.
Okay. And this is your first attempt in OPSC?
No, this is my third attempt.
Third attempt. So what had happened in first and second?
In first attempt, I took Electrical Engineering optional. Then I could not clear mains. In second attempt, I went to interview. Then I did not get the final round. And this is my third attempt.
This is your third. Yes. So last year also you had been selected for the interview.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So tell me something about your home district, which place you belong to.
I belong to Jaleswar. In the Baleswar district, it is in the Baleswar district, mm-hmm. And it is very near to West Bengal border, mm-hmm. And Jaleswar has various eminent personality, and it has occupied a very special place in the heart, in the place, in the Odisha history.
Okay, so that is Baleswar, right?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the origin of the word Baleswar, from where this word Baleswar has been taken?
Yes, sir. It has originated from Balaisor, sand in the town in the sea shore.
Okay. So you have stayed. One is your home district. Then you have also stayed in Sambalpur for around 1 year.
Yes, sir.
More than 1 year. And now you are currently also staying at Sambalpur.
Yes, sir.
From 2013 to 2018, it's like 7 years you are there.
5 years. Yes.
5 years you are there in Sambalpur, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Consistently you have also a good career. So, what is the reason you are interested to join civil services? You have done M.Tech from Burla.
Yes, sir.
And so you are in a technical field now, you are serving the society and serving the nation.
Yes, sir.
In your technical capability, what is the reason why you want to come into civil services?
Civil service was my childhood dream, and in technical field I am doing monotonous job which is like going 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. and specifically adhered to the only technical nature of the job. But I want to diversify my job profile, so I want to join civil services.
Okay. Coming to your hobbies.
Yes.
Following football. Or you don't play yourself?
I used to play in the school level. Mm-hmm. Then I started studying by my parental pressure, then I forgot to play. Now I'm not getting time.
Okay. And traveling also.
Traveling, sir.
So what all places you have traveled?
In the last 2 years I have gone to Haridwar, Rishikesh, then Vizag, then Hyderabad, then New Delhi, then all Odisha nearby Sambalpur places I visited.
Okay. So tell me the top 3 tourist places of your district, home district.
Of my district. First is Hirakud Dam. Working place or?
No, your home district.
Home district. First is Chandipur on sea, Chandipur beach. Then second one is Panchalingeshwar. Then third one is Bhusandeshwar.
Okay, and in Sambalpur?
In Sambalpur, first one is Hirakud Dam, second one is Samaleswari Temple, third one is Ghanteswari Temple, and that's Chiplima.
So you have got 9th rank in all Odisha, NRTS. What
yes,
is
sir.
This NRTS?
National Rural Talent Search Exam.
National Rural Talent Search Exam, okay. Good. What was the prize in this?
Prize I got award from Chief Minister Navin Pandak, Mr. Navin Pandak at that time. And annually stipend, I guess, 3,600 that time, 1999, 2001 that time.
For how many years you got the stipend?
Three years.
Yes.
8, 9, 10.
Then Mathematics Olympiad?
Yes, sir.
Class 6, 7, 8, 9 and 11. What is that, Mathematics Olympiad?
Mathematics Olympiad is a national level Olympiad. which is conducted by Methodist Association in Odisha and by national level. So if you get to score a specific mark, then you will selected, then you will get selected. I in the class 8, I got all Odisha 24 rank. Then I stayed at internship. I did an internship on mathematics at Sainik School. I went there and got award from at that time Governor Mr. Rajendra, M.M. Rajendra, at that time he was a governor. I got award from that.
Okay, fine. So currently you are working in OPTCL.
Yes,
what
sir.
Is the full form of that?
Orissa Power Transmission Corporation Limited.
Power Transmission,
yes sir.
So what is the state of generation of electricity in Orissa now? And tell me, is Orissa a energy deficient or surplus
state?
Now,
if we consider the current situation, it is deficient by 300 megawatt. Deficient by 300 megawatt because Upper Kola, I was watching yesterday SLDC. SLDC means State Load Dispatch Center work. Then that was Upper Kola is 0 megawatt and Vedanta, which is a major exporting industry, it is also exporting 0 megawatt because it has maintenance work. So that's why it is shortage by 300 megawatt. If we consider installed capacity, it means total how can we generate, then it's power surplus. And we can if we go to full potential, then we can export energy to outer state or outer grid. But today it's energy efficient, currently it is considering.
So what is the problem with
Kola? Upper Kola water level is 0. 625 is the highest capacity and it's 627 its height feet now. I mean 625 is the minimum capacity and it's 627. Now agriculture work will be done, then other multi-purpose work. So if we consider hold the water to generation, then it will vacant and it will be huge problem for the Upper Kola area.
Okay. Kola is in which district?
Koraput district, sir.
Koraput.
Jaipur.
So according to the installed capacity, which is the largest project in Odisha?
Upper Indravati.
600
megawatt.
600, that is working?
No, the total hydropower generation is according to yesterday, it is around 300 megawatt only. But total is 2000 megawatt. If we consider Bulla power only, its installed capacity is 200 megawatt approximately, but it is generating only 15 megawatt. Then if you consider Chipliwa power house, it's 72 megawatt installed capacity, but it's generating only 15 megawatt. So that's the huge problem. We are not maintaining properly. And first, second question is, whichever breakdown appearing, we are not going forward with a new machine or a new type of technology. That's the problem.
So why the installed capacity and the current generation, so much difference is there? What are the main issues?
If we consider Bulla power house only, there are 7 turbines there. So from 7 turbines, 4 are only maintenance condition. 4 are at their maintenance condition. And apart of 3, there are 1 or 2 are in working condition. 1 or 2 working condition, a third one is removed. Their new machine will come over. So from 1-2 machine only, they are generating 12 to 20, 30, that's the maximum capacity. And my grid is connected to Bulla grid directly. Sambalpur is directly generating, directly getting power from Bulla grid. And it's hardly 25, 30 megawatt at max. I am watching that, 30 megawatt.
Okay. So what can be the solution? Should we bring new machines, or what are the solutions according to you?
If we consider the water level of the water level of different dam, then there is the main problem. Water level, I mean, there is siltation problem in the Hirakud dam because we have seen that siltation problem and the sand accumulation are there very much in the Hirakud dam. If we clean the surface of the dam, then it may give up to 2 to 3 foot height extra. And if 2 to 3 feet extra means we can generate more electricity. So I guess apart of them, new turbines are needed for the Bulla power house or any other power system. Then also efficient technology, I mean, there are new technology up there in outer world, outer society, outer country, so we need to exert to that.
Okay. So apart from this hydropower energy, what are the other sources of energy in Odisha?
In Odisha is major is thermal power house. thermal powers, I mean there are two thermal houses operating in Odisha under Odisha government. One is Eep Thermal, which is present in Jharsuguda, and second one is Talcher Thermal. So from that only we are getting around 800 megawatt generation.
Okay, fine. So have you heard of something called subcritical and supercritical coal?
I have heard, but I don't know actually. Yes, I have heard that.
Okay. In Odisha, do we have any renewable source of energy?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There are biomass generation capacity in Bargad, inaugurated in Bargad now, and there are solar power is there, and there are wind power is operating in Gopalpur, Puri, Jagatsinghpur. That's the.
Okay.
And ORDA, Odisha Renewable Energy Power Development Corporation, and GDPA, Green Odisha Development, they're working on the renewable power sources.
So, what are the options that you have taken?
Sociology and Public Administration.
Sociology and Public Administration. Although you are from Electrical Engineering background.
Sir.
Why? What is the reason?
To score marks, sir. I could not get time in studying technical subjects like Geography or Mathematics or Electrical Engineering. But in my short time, which I could grasp quickly, then I took the subject. Sociology, Public Administration, I think I could grasp easily and with minimum time, so I took the subject.
Sociology and Public Administration. Okay. So, let us start with Sociology. Who is known as the father of Sociology?
Mr. Kamte.
Huh?
Kamte.
Okay. What was his contribution? What is his full name?
I don't know, sir.
Okay.
I forgot it actually.
Okay. You are unable to recall. So, what is his contribution to the field of sociology? Why is he called the father of sociology?
Yes, he first studied society as logical. He studied society as a logical thing. And he compared sociology with scientific study. Then he is called known as father of sociology.
Okay. And who is called the father of sociology in India? Indian sociology.
I don't know, sir. Indian sociologist, a book was written by him, but I could not recall actually.
What is meant by Sanskritization?
Yes, sir.
Who coined the term?
Who coined? I don't know.
It means Srinivas.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the meaning of the term Sanskritization? Tell me.
Sanskritization means when the lower caste or lower hierarchy of the people try to imitate the upper hierarchy of the people, their lifestyle, their food style, their working style. That's the called Sanskritization.
So, you are from Balasore. So, what are the tribes that are found in Balasore?
In Balasore, mainly Santal tribes are present there.
Santal tribes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me something about their culture, their language, their dance forms.
Santal are the very neat and clean. They very prefer sanitation, their main preference. And their dance, actually Chow dance, is Santali dance, is very famous. I visited that. And their food habit include normal Odia type of food. And they are very much accustomed to the Odia society. They are not varying to the society, not deviating to the society.
Okay. So, you mentioned about Chow dance, right?
Yes, sir.
So, there are basically many types of Chow dance.
Yes, sir.
Mainly two types.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what is the difference?
One is Purulia Chow dance, Purulia type. Second one is Moyurbanch type.
What is the difference?
Difference... I studied actually, but I cannot remember. Max type.
So
yes, sir.
Which style uses the mask?
I cannot remember. Purulia, I think, but I don't know actually.
Okay,
I forgot.
Fine.
I will study that.
Okay. So, tell me any three great personalities from Balasore, from any domain, freedom fighters or great statesmen, policy, doctors, military figures?
Fakir Mohan Senapati, Mr. Manoj Das, Mr. Radhanath Rai.
So tell something about these great people.
Mr. Fakir Mohan Senapati is known as father of Odia nationalism. And during that time, when the Bengali people used to influence the Odia language and did not recognize the Odia language, then he started writing novel short story in his own language. So which we normal native people can understand the language. So he wrote many novels like Chhaman Athagunta, Mamu, Revati, etc. So which is known as Vyasakavi of Odisha.
He is known as
Vyasakavi.
Yes, sir. And the second you said?
Manoj Das. Yes,
tell me something about
Manoj Das is native to Baleswar Sankhari, who has own Padmasri and Saraswata Sammana, one of the three Odia who has own Saraswata Sammana. And he has written a book like The Tiger in the Twilight and Amrutaphala. Amrutaphala, because of that, he won the Saraswata Sammana award. And third one is Radhanath Rai. Radhanath Rai is also he also worked very hard for the Odia revival, and he said the famous word, famous story. I cannot remember. Actually, sorry, I should not have told that word. No, Radhanath Rai, he coined a new very famous catchphrase. He said that famous. I cannot remember. I will recall that.
Okay, fine. So. What are the problems that you, as a resident of Baleswar, what are the problems which you have faced, or you think that your district is facing, and what solutions do you propose for those problems?
There are two problems here. One is migration problem, and second one is illegal use of cocaine. And that's the on banned substances. That's the main thing. Mm-hmm. And migration can be tackled by NRC type of National Register of Citizen type. And there are proper mechanism like identifying the migration problem, migration, and evaluate the hotspot. Hotspot, I mean, there where's the possible the conflict with the natives, with the migrant, that can be assessed. So that's the first step I need to take if I get to position myself that.
Okay. So what is the reason that, tell me in points, okay, how many reasons can you give me,
yes, sir,
for your decision to join the civil services, and you could have continued in your this technical job, isn't it?
Sir.
So what is the difference? Why you are interested for a job in civil services?
Job in is my childhood dream, sir. First one is my childhood dream. My parents used to tell me the story when they went to interact with the collector or tahsildar, how they used to feel. So they wanted to me in that type. So they are working very hard, or they want to see me in that position. Then third one is when I studied technical, then I thought I could contribute. I can go to the normal administrative line by studying. So I think that's the best thing by civil service.
Okay. Your other optional, one is sociology, other one is
public administration. Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So same question, who is known as the father of public administration?
Woodrow Wilson.
Woodrow Wilson, okay. Was he?
He was the first Democratic president of US, United States of America, and he was there at the time of World War I.
Okay. So, what did he propose? What were his thoughts about public administration?
He proposed the principle of public administration, and he used to say public administration can be studied differently, not according to political science. And he studied first logical use of public administration. He proposed the logical way of public administration.
Okay. So he proposed something called dichotomy.
Yes, a dichotomy of yes,
between
public administration and political science.
And political science, okay. So have you heard the name Anton Mayo?
Yes, sir, I have heard.
What was his contribution?
He gave the human behavior proposal.
He conducted some famous
yes,
experiments.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about those experiments?
I cannot remember the names, but I know the basic of them. There was thought that if you give more money, more pay, more light, and more efficient working structure, then the working style, then the working productivity will go high. But Anton Mayo did not tell that. He divided two groups. One was given a light and food and a specific facility. Another one was thus they used to tell coordinate themselves and tell the working. So we found that there is no difference actually. The first one, second one was there. Actually, I cannot remember. Sorry, I did not tell.
Okay, so you have heard about the acronym POSTCOL.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Tell me.
POSTCOL. PP for process. No, sir. Sorry. O for organizing. POSS for staffing. D for direction, C for coordinating, R for report, and B for budgeting.
First one, P?
P for
planning.
Planning, yes sir, planning.
Who coined this postcard?
Postcard was coined by, forget that, sorry, I will study that.
Gullick, huh?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Gullick.
Gullick.
Okay, you have heard about the X and Y theory
yes,
of Herzberg.
Yes, sir.
What is that theory? Just tell me in brief.
X is the motivational theory, which we can.
So one are motivational factors, huh. Other are?
Another demotivation. Demotivation, what?
We used a particular word.
Hygiene. Yes, sir. Hygiene.
Okay. So you have studied the Maslow's need of hierarchy of needs. Which is the highest in the hierarchy?
Self-actualization.
So suppose if I ask you, what event will be self-actualization for you? Suppose you get rank 1 in this exam, will that be self-actualization for you? Or what? If what happens, you will feel that you have reached that level of self-actualization?
For me, when the people will remember my work, and that's for me the self actualization. When the society will give a identification that he is a good guy, he is a nice boy, he did some work for our society, then that's for me self actualization. People should remember me, not by rank, but by deeds.
Okay, so you are working in OPT cell, so tell me something about OPT cell. Who is the current MD or CMD?
Mr. Hemant Sharma.
Okay. So suppose tomorrow you are given to head a public sector, state public sector undertaking, okay, which is in bad shape, right? Economically, lot of losses are there, and you have to revive it. Because you are from engineering background, the government has given you the task to revive it. So tell me, what are the steps you will take initially, what you will try to do, and condition of that firm is very bad. Okay, it is like if you are unable to restructure it, or you are unable to get some profit, then maybe the government will sell it, disinvest it. Okay, so what are you going to do?
Whenever I will take the PSU, take over the PSU, then I will study detailed analysis of the PSU. I mean, what are the branches are there, how many persons are there, and if any person is, then the second one is identify the problem. Second one is if any people are necessary or not, how much people are contributing to the objective of the organization, and if they are, if if any overstaffing is there not. Then third one is that I will try to financially, I will do the financially whatever may be needed. I mean by directing them to do this, to do that, and maybe approach the government for the funding. Then I will take necessary steps accordingly. What is the problem I have seen? Then I will take necessary steps. So.
Okay. So, do you read newspaper?
Yes, sir.
Which newspaper do you read?
Times of India.
Times of India. Okay. So, you see in Times of India, below that, you know, what is the special significance of every day it gives? Have you ever seen that? Today is this day.
Okay.
So, let's say 25th December, it will be written 25th December is Christmas. Or, you know, particular day, these things are celebrated on this particular day. Have you seen that in Times of India?
No, I have not seen that.
So tell me, today, what is the significance of today?
December 7th.
Yes. Something to do with army?
Sir?
Army, Indian Defence.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Vijay Divas, I don't know, sir. I did not.
Okay, just go through that part. Okay, and recently the World Hockey Men's World Cup is going on in Bhubaneswar. So, can you tell me how many teams are participated in this tournament?
16 teams.
16 teams are participated. Okay, which group is said to be the most difficult group because all the big players are there?
I have not analyzed that.
It is called the group of death.
Yes, sir. Not analyzed. I don't know.
So, can you tell me something about India's matches? What India has done till now? How many it has lost and how many it has won and how many it has drawn?
First one is India South Africa. Then India has won. But by 4-0 or 4-1. 5-0, I don't know.
Okay,
the second one was India versus Belgium. It was draw 2-2. And third was India versus Canada. That's one schedule when I cannot remember.
Okay, just check that. Okay. What is the mascot for this World Hockey?
Oli,
what is that?
Oli is Olive Ridley. Olive Ridley is and native to Odisha coast.
Apart from Odisha, Olive Ridley is also found in another place where they also do mass testing. Which is that place?
Andhra Pradesh.
No, not in India. Abroad?
Not. No, I don't know.
No?
No.
Okay. So, why do you think that the Olive Ridley turtles, okay, they have chosen, where is their main nesting site?
Gahirmatha.
Gahirmatha. We have such a big, huge coastline. They would have chosen any other place. What are the factors which have led them to choose Gahirmatha as their preferred spot?
Gahirmatha, Brahmani, Baitarani and Mahanadi. Three rivers pass through Gahirmatha or Gahirmatha. Then it also very much safe for them. No specific danger to them. So they choose Gahirmatha and it's very plain surfaces there.
Okay, tell me, recently there has been some currency swap agreement.
Yes, sir.
India and some other country. Which is that other country?
Japan?
Hmm. Or some Middle East country?
Middle East country, UAE and there.
What is the meaning of currency swap?
Currency swap agreement is that when India needs fund, then we don't have to go for dollar. We have to just currency swap the Japanese yen or UAE's currency with us. And when we solve the problem, then we can give them back in their own currency.
Okay, fine. So, have you heard the name of Jamal Khashoggi?
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about him, why
he
is in news?
He was a Saudi Arabia journalist who is critical of royal clown princess. So he used to reside in Turkey. So he was killed recently by the in the Saudi Arabia embassy by the embassy persons.
So recently, some countries have come under Chinese debt. Okay, yes, in and around those who are the neighbors of India.
Yes, sir.
Who are the which are those countries? Two, three countries are there.
Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Maldives.
Maldives. Okay. And what has been? What are the governments? Or what has been the response of these three governments to the Chinese debt?
Sri Lanka gave over 99 years lease to Humberto Port to the Chinese government. Maldives and recently is under the bridge on the it has not gone under debt, but it's now going it will come under. So they want to cancel some project, so which can be beneficial for them. And Pakistan is in need of fund, so they want fund anyhow, so they can go through the debt fund.
So you have heard about the CPC?
Yes, sir.
What is the starting point of the CPC?
Gwadarpat. Gwadarpat to Asghar. Asghar to Gwadarpat. Asghar. Chinese site.
Which province that is?
Xinjiang province
always is in the news,
yes,
for
sir.
Some reason.
Yes, sir.
What is the reason?
Xinjiang province is the native to the Muslim population. Kazakh population and also Muslim Uyghur population. So they do not want Chinese authority on them. So they want their own independence, their own autonomy. But Chinese government is always pressuring to them and want to control them. That's why it's always in news.
So, have you heard of something called the Blue Cross recently? Blue Cross. It was awarded to one of India's finest sportsperson who has won gold medal in Olympics. How many Indians have won gold medal in Olympics?
Individually, only one. Individually, we consider.
Okay.
Mr. Abhinav Bindra.
He was awarded Blue Cross twice, so can you tell me something
no.
What is Blue Cross?
No.
Okay. So, in international relations, what's some problem now going on between the US and the China, especially on the reason is that one of the top executives of a Chinese telecommunication company was arrested in Canada on the insistence of the US. Have you read it or
no?
Okay, you have heard about the company Huawei?
Huawei? Yes, mobile company.
Yes, one of the top, actually the daughter of the owner. Okay, she has been arrested. Okay, fine. So, you told that the various reasons for your choice of civil services. Okay. So this is your third attempt, right?
Yes, sir.
So suppose you are not selected this time. What will be your next, how will you react and what will be your next step?
Then what I think I have some shortcoming. Then I will study hard. And first thing, I will see the marks where I scored the minimum mark or where I did the bad thing, did the worst thing. Then I will try to correct it and gap next time with heavy heart.
Okay. Now, last year what happened? You got dyslexia with subject?
Sociology paper 2.
Okay, so you worked on it this year?
Yes,
how
sir.
How was the performance this year?
It was good.
Huh?
It was good.
It was good.
Yes, sir.
Overall, it was good.
Yes, man, so it's good.
Okay, fine. So suppose, you are a technical person. Okay, you are already in a good job. You are highly qualified. You are in a technical job. Why should I choose you? Suppose there are two people. There is another person who is unemployed. Okay, he has done a general MA, let's say in history. And you are already in a job, you are also a technical person, you easily get a job anywhere else. So, why should I choose you? Give me three concrete reasons why I should choose you and not the other Mr. X, who is a general, you know, he has done MA in history and he is unemployed.
I cannot tell that because you have a perception.
Of course. So you tell me, why should I choose you? You tell me the positive sides of you, three reasons why you should choose you.
I am on a management job, now assistant manager, that's managing people. So in the civil services, I think I could apply that my ability in here also, in civil services also. Second one is the only experienced person, so I know that, so I know the organization structure, organization working style. So I think I can contribute to, I can contribute to the civil services.
So suppose you are the you are given the charge of selecting one civil servant, right? And there are two candidates in the interview. First candidate is extremely honest, but he is inefficient. Second candidate is just the opposite. He is extremely efficient, but he is not honest. Okay, maybe he is prone to corruption and all those things. Which officer you will choose and why?
I will choose the first person, honest person, because inefficiency can be corrected by giving working or by training, by specific objective, that can be corrected. So but dishonesty cannot be corrected.
Okay. So what is your opinion about how the government has handled the Sabarimala issue, the government of Kerala? Suppose you had been in charge, you had been the chief minister of Kerala, how differently would you have handled the situation?
Being the chief minister of Kerala, I am bound to obey. I am bound to obey the Supreme Court order. So I think I will go with the same process as the Kerala government is now undergoing. But I should refrain the activist group. What the government has said, it's not for activist, it's for the devotional purpose. So devotional women should be allowed, but not activist type when the recently another religion women, they want to forcefully want to show that because I am the feminist, so I can do whatever I want. That's the not good thing. So I should do exactly what the government is doing by giving proper law and order situation.
So, I will come back to your once more to your optionals.
Yes, sir.
Sociology and public administration. Okay, I'll ask some questions quite fast. So, you tell me if you know them. Okay. Who is associated with the decision making theory?
Sir?
Decision making theory.
Huh.
Which administrative thinker is associated with the decision making theory?
Simon.
Simon,
what is your
full name? Richard Simon?
No, sorry, I don't know, sir. Simon.
Okay, just
know
Simon, okay, fine. So, there are various leadership styles, okay. Tell me, who is a lesser style leader?
I cannot remember,
is
I had studied. No, not very straight. He is totally disoriented, disorganized type.
Is that disorganized or he generally leaves it to the...
To the authority and give orders to them only. I supervise them only. That's
okay. Have you heard the term span of control?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Span of control means how many subordinate I can, a supervisor can control and work on them.
So, have you heard the term Gracchus formula?
Sir?
Gracchus formula? Gracchus formula or Gracchus ratio?
Yes, sir.
Related
I can.
To span of control?
Yes, sir. Yes,
what
sir.
Is that?
Formula? Sorry, I will study tomorrow and day after tomorrow. I don't know actually optional.
Okay, you have not gone through.
Yes, 2 days I will study optional.
Okay. So, have you heard something called MOTA?
Nota, yes.
What is Nota?
None of the above option.
None of the above. So suppose let's say There are three people, okay, for testing and evaluation, ABC. Highest, and there are 100 people. 70 have voted for NOTA. 11 people have voted for A, and 10 people have voted for B, and 9 people have voted for C.
Hmm.
Who will win?
A.
A will win. Why 70% people have voted for NOTA?
Because in the NOTA option, there is not given that if the NOTA wins, then they will do election or rejection of the candidate. Whichever, a part of NOTA, whichever is secured maximum votes, he will win.
So what is this system called, where the person gets the maximum votes wins?
Pass the system, pass the first,
okay, fine. So, you know, you have come for an interview to the OPSC, right? OPSC is a statutory body?
No, constitutional body.
It's a constitutional body. Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir. Sure.
What are the types of public service commissions that can be formed according to the constitution?
First one is Union Union Public Service Commission. Mm-hmm. Second one is State Public Service Commission. Third one is Joint Public Service Commission.
Any example of Joint Public Service Commission now?
Punjab Haryana Public Service Commission. Joint.
Are you sure there is a Punjab and Haryana Public Service Commission? Are you talking about the High Court?
No, High Court is common. But jointly there is Punjab Haryana of PSC.
Are you sure? Are you guessing?
I guess.
No, no, don't guess.
No, sorry, 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 sir. I don't know, sir.
Okay. If you don't know, just say that. No, sir, I'm aware or I don't know. Okay. Recently, now in Odisha, in Western Odisha, there is a because you are also from Sambalpur, you are working in Sambalpur. There is a demand of the advocates and the common people also, that a bench of the Odisha High Court should be set up there. Okay, in Western Odisha, because people are facing lot of problems and coming to Cuttack. Right. What is your opinion on that? And this has been a long-standing demand. Even state government has written letters to the central government. So what are the rules or what are the requirements? If they are fulfilled, then only the Supreme Court accepts for a bench of the High Court.
Yes, sir. There is one Jaswan Singh committee. Jaswan Singh committee. It has given separate. It has given specific conditions like population of the region, how many socio educational background of their population, and how much distance from the High Court. High Court. That's the position condition. And apart from them, central government will only accept the proposal from the state government if they give salary to the High Court benches and specific population, not like region, specific town or city. And apart from that, High Court Chief Justice of High Court should oblige the specific conditions of the state government, then only central government will follow up the principle.
What is the problem in Odisha? Why they are demanding for such a long time? Why the bench is not being set up?
Because of not unity of the Odisha.
But all the conditions are being fulfilled or not?
Yes, but unity is not there. Political reasons also are there. And unity is not also there. Political reasons, I mean, unity not there. There is Western Odisha, Rourkela is demanding on bench should be on that place. Sambalpur demanding should be on that place. Then recently Balangir is demanding because it should be on that place. And Kalahandi was demanding it should be at Kalahandi. So there are four possible benches are there. If we give High Court bench to Sambalpur, then maybe possibility of revolt or that type in the proposed area. So that's why the best thing is talk with the people and the interested person, interested capacity, and decide a bench, because it's necessary. But I think for me, bench in Western Odisha is necessary for me.
Okay, so that will be the end of the interview.
Okay.
Thank you,
sir.